What's this? What's that? Oh, nice. That's a cool stick figure shirt. Damn, dog. I didn't.
Dread Rum's brewed from swamp weeds, so its effect is as bold as its flavor.
What's up? I mean, can they really print that many of them? Thank you.
things could be cops.
Huh.
Can't be too careful these days. Breakers used to come here for target practice. Used to play a little game. See who could bust the most targets and the fewest shots. He's focused. He's armed. And he's off. Shot just happens in a flash. He puts on the right solid performance. Kid ain't had enough of the Breakers' barracks.
Yeah, dude. It's like, pretty brutal.
Thank you.
takes practice, and a mighty strong bow helps too.
Thank you.
done bad at all. I almost don't believe it when he says he passed the Breaker's challenge. Time to get what he came for and get on out. He heads for the east side, where windbags used to keep the local forge. Somehow that old forge is still standing. Inside the forge, he can fine-tune those instruments of his. With a good length of Miska, that bow's like new again. Guess again. The rest of the path is gone for good. and his city crest won't bring it back. Odd place to find the likes of Percy the Snitch. Keeps telling himself he better watch his step. Heads for the biggest dump in town, Scumbag Alley. Some scumbag still feeding off the city's own trash. And there he is, the oldest scumbag of them all, Gershel. For Gershel's sunny disposition. They always said old Gershel wouldn't go without a fight. Up north is where the gas fella foreman used to live, tending to his flock. Gas fellas all dress alike. Kids wondering the same thing. And there it is, but it's locked down tight in an alloy cage. A blustery old foreman's keeping his fellas in check, almost like he's showboating for the crowd. Now there's a new marshal in town. He hears the whole place groan, but it's too tough to fall. Might as well check the other side streets before leaving this hole. Comes back. just like I knew he would. The core hums in his pack, the monument's calling for it. The windbags used to be all right, then the calamity took the floor out from under him. Ain't always much to say. Kid does it again. Only fair he decides what we build next. A lot of things need fixing up in this world, and we can start right here. Kid's lifelong friends looking fit to keep on fighting. Picked up traces of other cores while the kid was out. In better days, the melting pot was sealed tighter than the skin on the squirt. Of all the plants to survive the calamity, it had to be stab weeds. Blasted things hurt like a broken heart. Cuts down every stab weed like there's gonna be a prize for it. If there's a core, he figures it ought to be deeper down. Stuck inside one of those fancy cages. No breaking a cage like that, but the kid tries anyway. Gotta find a way to spring it open. Some of this stuff lying around is downright dangerous. Throws a switch. Now what could possibly go wrong? Quite a bit, as it turns out. The cage starts lifting from the core ever so slow. All Kid can do is wait. Shipments start falling in. Not every squirt's born bad. Some spring to the Kid's defense. Judging by the movement of the cage, it's gonna take a little while. Scumbags don't take kindly to interlopers. Even some gas fellas take his corner. Heard it pop that mean old foreman. At this rate, maybe 5 more minutes, maybe 30. Hard to tell. Squirts get real territorial around the core. Then a shipment of free samples shows up. Thanks for sure, that cage is awful heavy. It's a troublesome scene to be sure. Moments left, and the core goes free. 10, 9, 8, 7. You give or take a few seconds. Finally, the core's within reach. And done. He's got it. Just gotta get to the nearest barge. I still remember the look on his face after that one.
I
is that? The whole thing.
Neat rubber, and it's like, it's a cool color too. Would you like to use a monitor and keyboard in lieu of your laptop? As the controller. Okay. Well, I mean, yeah, that one right there. So whichever screen's like. I figure that one's got stand and like whatever. Yeah. But I was gonna say what you can do is you can just close your laptop and set it off to the side. So that should be good.
I
want
to do that too.
Alright.
How do we do it?
Good. I got you.
Sick.
Here, that's a keyboard and USB.
I want a keyboard.
You don't want a keyboard?
In order to get the...
Yo, did she send you money or what?
She hasn't.
I think that'll be...
Yeah.
I told her... Or I... had a birthday talk with her.
Turns out those old bones still have some spark in them. Folks voyaged across the boundless sea to found Ceylandia. It was good living here for a while. Sometimes a single look says it all. Thank you. Fetching fizz is like a mouthful of nails, but the benefits are worth it. The old world's finished, but the new world's just getting started. The Bastion's a place of peace, but we can hold our own if we have to.
It should be down here.
A repeater goes with a hammer better than a box of nails. Couples used to walk the sundown path. Kid ain't here for pleasure, though. But then, somebody gets to the core before the kid. Floor starts giving way under the lightest step. The single panic squirt could bring the whole place down. Fragments of the old world rain from the sky. Stray valuables are lying everywhere. Security's all fired up. See, the path was intended for leisurely strolling and such. Not so much for noise and tomfoolery. Sky bridges link the path together. One of them bridges whips the kid along. Air travel always was an iffy proposition. Quick and careful is the only way to go. The calamity changed everything, even where the wind blows. Well, if we mastered the winds in the old days, we can do it again. But the question is, who else could have taken the core? Well, ain't no survivor stole the thing. Ship live munitions down the path. He's wise to toss those things plenty far away. Even gas fellas need some shut-eye from time to time. They get real cranky when you wake them up. Toil, Kid keeps coming back to an overwhelming question. Who else could have survived the calamity? So he didn't find the core that time, but that ain't about to stop us. What else is there to say? Squirt cider will toughen you right up. Too bad about the musty aftertaste. No place better than Trapper Shingle for learning to tread light and shoot straight. Trappers had to tread real careful here, else take a nasty fall. They train themselves by clearing out the targets while not clearing out the floor. Any good trapper knows never to take a step till the time is right. Expert trapper's got something extra to give him an edge. To To think a rickety place like the Shingle survived, and so little else did. That ought to make those fangs sink in nice and deep. Kid decides to keep working his aim and footwork on the shingle. Best time to pick a new spot was when swapping magazines. Master trappers got what they needed for a better hunt. The trappers would have been impressed with how the kid handled the shingle. Ware whiskey has no scent, but tastes like a peppered boot heel. It's not for everyone. Windbag Ranch was built for gathering squirt extract in copious supply. Ain't nothing more healthful. Some folks showed up to make a fast buck with nothing but a knife. Always time for juice and squirts, they used to say. At least the little fellas can't feel a thing. Some squirts try to flee on instinct. Best to put them away first, before they rile up the others. Place gets awful slick sometimes. Slippery little devils. Squirts can be dangerous, like any livestock. Kid cuts all of them down soon enough. Kid comes back from Windbag Ranch, smelling good and ripe. The repeater and machete, favorite choices of the Ura hunters we once fought. The little Zolwood oil and that blade shines like a light. War machetes are so quick, you gotta keep a good grip on them. The ranch was always looking for good help.
Where was he? Had received to take his life. Big Bastion, you should hear the announcements. Famously, the game's pretty famous now. Thank you.
Kid makes short work of them things. There's always more squirts to go around. Carves through all of them in a flash.